नमस्कार, जय श्री कृष्ण। श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासदि गौर भक्त वृंदा रिजुविनेटिंग टेक्स्ट 11 एंड टेक्स्ट 12 ऑफ चैप्टर 1 द एक्टिविटीज ऑफ महाराज प्रियव्रत ऑफ फिफ्थ कैंटो द क्रिएटिव इंपेटस ऑफ श्रीमद् भागवतम। टेक्स्ट 11 श्री भगवान उवाच निबोध तातेदमृतम ब्रवीमि मासूयितुम देवमरहस्य प्रमेयम वयम भवस्ते तत एष देवऋषिर् वहम सर्वे विवशा यस्य दिष्टम। लॉर्ड ब्रह्मा द सुप्रीम पर्सन विद इन दिस यूनिवर्स सेड माय डियर प्रियव्रत काइंडली हियर अटेंटिवली व्हाट आई शैल से टू यू। डू नॉट बी जेलस ऑफ द सुप्रीम लॉर्ड हु इज बियॉन्ड आवर एक्सपेरिमेंटल मेजरमेंट्स। ऑल ऑफ अस इंक्लूडिंग लॉर्ड शिव योर फादर एंड द ग्रेट सेज नारद मुनि मस्ट कैरी आउट द ऑर्डर ऑफ द सुप्रीम। वी कैनॉट डेविएट फ्रॉम हिज ऑर्डर। Out of the 12 great authorities in devotional service, 4 Lord Brahma himself, his son Narad, Swayambhuva Manu and Lord Shiva were present before Priyavrat. They were accompanied by many other authoritative sages. Brahma first wanted to impress upon Priyavrat that although these great personalities are all authorities, they cannot possibly disobey the orders of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, who is described in this verse as Dev, which means always glorious. The power, glory and potencies of the Supreme Personality of Godhead can never be diminished. In the Ishvopanishad, the Lord is described as a papa vidha, which indicates that he is never affected by anything materially considered sinful. Srimad Bhagavatam similarly describes the Supreme Personality of Godhead as being so powerful that nothing we might consider abominable that can affect him. An example given sometimes to explain the position of the Supreme Lord is that of the sun, which evaporates urine from the earth but is never affected by contamination. The Supreme Lord can never be accused of doing anything wrong. When Lord Brahma went to induce Priyavrat to accept the responsibility for ruling this universe, he did not come whimsically. He was following the dictations of the Supreme Lord. Indeed, Brahma and other genuine authorities never do anything without his permission. The Supreme Lord is situated in everyone's heart. In the beginning of Srimad Bhagavatam, it is said, Tene Brahma Rudaya Adi Kavaya. The Lord dictated Vedic knowledge to Brahma from his heart. The more a living entity is purified by devotional service, the more he comes in direct contact with the Supreme Personality of Godhead, as confirmed in Srimad Bhagavad Gita. Tesham Satata Yuktanam Bhajatam Priti Purvakam ददामि बुद्धि योगम तमो येन माम उपयान्ति ते। टू दोज हु आर कॉन्स्टेंटली डिवोटेड एंड वर्शिप मी विथ लव आई गिव द अंडरस्टैंडिंग बाय विच दे कैन कम टू मी। भगवद्गीता 10.10। देयरफॉर लॉर्ड ब्रह्मा डिड नॉट कम टू प्रियव्रत बाय हिज ओन विम्स। रादर इट इज अंडरस्टूड दैट ही हैज बीन ऑर्डर्ड टू परसुएड प्रियव्रत बाय द सुप्रीम पर्सनैलिटी ऑफ गॉडहेड हुज एक्टिविटीज कैनॉट बी अंडरस्टूड बाय मटेरियल सेंसेस एंड हु इज देयरफॉर डिस्क्राइब्ड हियरिन एज अप्रमेय। दस लॉर्ड ब्रह्मा फर्स्ट एडवाइस प्रियव्रत टू हियर हिज वर्ड्स विथ अटेंशन एंड विदाउट एनवी। वेन वन इज इंड्यूस्ड टू परफॉर्म सर्टन एक्ट्स डिस्पाइट हिज डिजायर टू डू समथिंग एल्स इज इंडिकेटेड हियरिन। वन कैनॉट डिसोबे द ऑर्डर ऑफ द सुप्रीम लॉर्ड इवन इफ ही इज एज पावरफुल एज लॉर्ड शिव लॉर्ड ब्रह्मा मनु और द ग्रेट सेज नारद। ऑल दीज authorities are certainly very powerful, but they do not have the power to disobey the order of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Since Lord Brahma came to Priyavrat in accordance with the orders of the Supreme Lord, he first wanted to dispel any suspicions that he might be acting as Priyavrat's enemy. Lord Brahma was following the orders of the Supreme Lord, and therefore it is worthwhile for Priyavrat to accept Lord Brahma's order as the Lord desired. Text 12. Na yasya kashachita tapasa vidyaya va na yoga viryen manishaya va nai vartha dharmaih paratah svatoya kritam vihantum tanubhruda vibhuyat. One cannot avoid the order of the Supreme Personality of Godhead nor by the strength of severe austerities, an exalted Vedic education, or the power of mystic yoga, physical prowess, or intellectual activities. nor can one use his power of religion or his material opulence or by any other means, either by himself or with the help of others, to defy the orders of the Supreme Lord. That is not possible for any living being, from Brahma down to the ant. In the Garga Upanishad, Garga Muni says to his wife, Etasya va aksharasya prashasane gargi surya chandra masau vidhrutau tishthatah. O my wife Gargi, everything is under the control of the Supreme Personality of God. Even the sun, the moon and all other controllers and demigods like Lord Brahma and King Indra are all under his control. An ordinary human being or animal who has accepted a material body cannot go beyond the jurisdiction of the Supreme Personality of Godhead's control. A material body includes senses. However, the sense activities of so-called scientists who try to be free from God's law or the laws of nature are useless. This is also confirmed in Bhagavad Gita 7.14. Mama Maya Duratyaya. It is impossible to surpass the control of material nature, for the Supreme Personality of Godhead is working behind it. Sometimes we are proud of our austerities, penances and mystic yogic powers. But it is clearly stated herein that one cannot surpass the laws and directions of the Supreme Personality of Godhead either by dint of mystic power, a scientific education or austerities and penances. It is not possible. The word Manishya by intelligence is of special significance. Priyavrat might argue that Lord Brahma was requesting him to accept family life and the responsibility of ruling over the universe. Although Narad Muni had advised him not to enter household life and be entangled in material affairs, whom to accept would be a puzzle for Priyavrat, because both Lord Brahma and Narad Muni are authorities. Under the circumstances, the use of the word Manishaya is very appropriate, for it indicates that since both Narad Muni and Lord Brahma are authorities to give instruction, Priyavrat should neglect neither of them but should use his intelligence to follow the advice of both. To solve such dilemmas, Srila Rupa Goswami has given a very clear conception of intelligence. He says, Anasaktasya Vishayan Yatharham Upayunjataha Nirbandha Krishna Sambandhe Yuktam Vairagyam Uchchate. Vishayan, material affairs, should be accepted without attachment and everything should be dovetailed with the service of the Lord. That is real intelligence, Manishaya, because to become a family man or king in the material world is not harmful if one accepts everything for Krishna's service. That necessitates clear intelligence. Mayavadi philosophers say, Brahma Satyam Jagan Mithya. This material world is false and only the absolute truth is real. However, an intelligent devotee in the line of Lord Brahma and the great sage Narad, or in other words in the Brahma Sampradaya, does not consider this world false. That which is created by the Supreme Personality of Godhead cannot be false, but using it for enjoyment, everything is meant to be enjoyed by the Supreme Personality of Godhead, as confirmed in Bhagavad Gita 5.29. Bhoktaram Yajna Tapasam Sarva Loka Maheshwaram. The Supreme Personality of Godhead is the Supreme Proprietor and Enjoyer, and therefore everything should be dovetailed for his enjoyment and service, regardless of one's circumstances, favorable or unfavorable. One should use everything to serve the Supreme Lord. That is the perfect way to use one's intelligence. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare.